Hello everyone, today we will discuss lateral appendages. So the lateral appendages means the flagellas contain small hair like structures. So they are called as flagellas. So the flagellas are presenting on the one or two or more rows of small hair like structures. So they are called as lateral appendages. Lateral appendages means the flagellum bear one or two or one or two or more rows of small hair-like structure, short hair-like structures. Small hair-like structures is called lateral appendages. Lateral appendages means, so presenting on the flagella. The flagella contain one or two or more rows of lateral appendages. Small hair-like structures is called as lateral appendages. Lateral appendages means the flagella contain one row or two rows or more rows of lateral hair-like structures. Small or short hair-like structures present on the flagellum. So they are called as lateral appendages. So the based on the arrangement of lateral appendages, so the lateral appendages are the five types. Based on arrangement. Based on arrangement of lateral appendages, so they are the five types. Based on arrangement of lateral appendages, so they are called as, there are five types. First one, stichonematic. Second one, pantanematic. Third one, acronematic. Fourth one, pantacronematic. Fifth one, anematic. So they are the based on the arrangement of lateral appendages. So they are the five types. First one, stichonematic. Second one, pantonematic. Third one, acronematic. Fourth one, pantacronematic. Fifth one, anematic. Stichonematic, pantonematic, acronematic, pantacronematic, anematic. So based on the arrangement of lateral appendages. First one, stichonematic. Stichonematic means, so the flagellum contain ఓన్లీ వన్ రో ఆఫ్ లాటరల్ అపెండేజెస్ ద ఫ్లాజెల్లం కంటెయిన్ ఓన్లీ వన్ రో ఆఫ్ లాటరల్ అపెండేజెస్ ఫ్లాజెల్లం కంటెయిన్ వన్ రో ఆఫ్ లాటరల్ అపెండేజెస్ one row of lateral appendages. So the flagellum contain only one row of lateral appendages. The flagellum has a one row of lateral appendages. And the so they are called as stichonematic. Stichonematic means the flagellum contain only one row of lateral appendages. So they are called as stichonematic. Draw the diagram stichonematic. So they are the flagellum. So the flagellum contains only one row of lateral appendages. The flagellum contains only one row of lateral appendages. So they are called as stichonematic. Only one side presenting on the lateral appendage. So they are the flagellum. The flagellum contains only one row of lateral appendages. So they are called as stichonematic. They are called as stichonematic. Example, euglena. Example, euglena. So they are called as stichonematic. Stichonematic. Example, euglena. Example, euglena. Next, second one, pantonematic. Second one, pantonematic. Second one, pantonematic. Pantonematic. So the pantonematic means the flagellum contain two rows of lateral appendages. Pantonematic means the flagellum contain have a two or more rows of lateral appendages. The flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages. Two or more rows of lateral appendages. So they are called as pantonematic. Pantonematic means the flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages. So they are called as pantonematic. Example, so see the diagram, pantonematic. So the flagellum contain a two or many rows of lateral appendages. So comparing to these two diagrams, they are only one side presenting on the lateral appendages. So they are the left side is presenting, right side is absent. Right side is presenting, left side is absent. Only one side presenting on the hair-like structures. So they are called as stichonematic. So in this diagram, the flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages. So they are called as pantonematic. Pantonematic. Example, peranema. Peranema means, so they are the pantonematic. Pantonematic means the flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages. So they are called as pantonematic. Example, peranema. Third one, acronematic. So the acronematic means the flagellum contain a lateral appendages are absent. Thus type of flagellum do not appear lateral appendages and terminal so the acronymatic the flagellum do not contain lateral appendages lateral appendages the flagellum do not contain lateral appendages but they are contain a so they are presenting on the terminal filament is present terminal filament is present so the flagellum do not contain lateral appendages are absent but only terminal filament is present see the diagram so they are the lateral appendages so they are the flagellum the flagellum absent of lateral appendages but it contain terminal filament so these are called as acronymatic they are called as acronymatic example chlamydomonas so they are called as acronymatic next one fourth one pantacronymatic so the pantacronymatic means the flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages and terminal filament is present the flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages two or more rows of lateral appendages and a terminal filament is present terminal filament is present so two or more rows of lateral appendages are present and terminal filament is present so they are called as pantacronymatic so the diagram So these are the terminal filament is present and two or more rows of lateral appendages also present so this type is called as pantacronymatic pantacronymatic means the lateral appendage the flagellum contain a two or more rows of lateral appendages and terminal filament is present so they are called as pantacronymatic final last one. So example UCLS, example UCLS. Example UCLS. Next final last one, anematic. Fifth type, anematic. So the anematic means, so the flagellum, lateral appendages are absent and terminal filament are absent. Lateral appendages are absent. Lateral appendages are absent and terminal filament also absent. Terminal filament also absent. So they are called as anematic. Anematic means lateral appendages are absent and terminal filaments are absent. So they are called as anematic. Anematic. See the diagram, anematic. So they are the only one lateral appendage. So flagellum. So the lateral appendages are absent. Terminal filament are absent. So this type is called as anematic. Anematic. So they are the lateral appendages. Lateral appendages. Once revised, lateral appendages means the flagellum. Flagellum means, so they are the flagellum. The flagellum contain a short hair-like structures. So they are called as lateral appendages. So the based on the arrangement of lateral appendages, they are the five types. First one, psychonematic, acronematic, sorry, psychonematic, pantonematic, acronematic, pantacronematic, anematic. First one, psychonematic. Psychonematic means the flagellum contain only one row of lateral appendages. Only one row of lateral appendages. So they are called as psychonematic. Second one, pantonematic. Pantonematic means the flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages. The flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages. So they are called as pantonematic. Third one, acronematic. Acronematic means the flagellum do not contain lateral appendages, but they contain terminal filament. So they are called as acronematic. Fourth one, pantacronematic. Pantacronematic means the flagellum contain two or more rows of lateral appendages and terminal filament also present. So they are called as pantonematic. Finally, fifth one, anematic. Anematic means, so the lateral appendages are absent and terminal filament also absent. So they are called as anematic. So they are the lateral appendages.